Welcome, you're watching the news with me, Anubhuti Gaur. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. Hours after Supreme Court rejected his curative petition, Nirbhaya case convict Pawan Kumar Gupta filed a mercy plea with the president. While the Patiala House Court has dismissed convict Pawan's application seeking stay on his execution, Nirbhaya's mother, Asha Devi, hailed Delhi Court's verdict, saying that she has always had faith in the judicial system of the country since the beginning. She went on to say, the convicts will finally be hanged tomorrow and I'm happy about it. The Supreme Court today agreed to hear cases against BJP leaders that are accused of hate speeches filed by the victims of last week's Delhi violence in which 46 people have been killed. The Chief Justice, however, said that the Supreme Court wishes for peace but has limitations to its power to control such violence. He said that we are not equipped to prevent these things from happening. This is a kind of pressure on us. We can't handle so much pressure. Petitions have called for FIRs against BJP leaders Kapil Mishra, Parvesh Verma, Anurag Thakur and Abhay Verma. The court will be hearing the matter on Wednesday. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has criticised the Centre for Violence in Northeast Delhi, in which 46 people have been killed. Banerjee has also claimed that she has been told that it was a planned genocide in Northeast Delhi, later shown as a riot. She said that Delhi police is under the centre. There were Delhi police, CRPF and the CISF, but nothing was done. And BJP is so shameless that they have not even sought an apology. In a horrific incident, seven boys who appeared for their class 10th board examinations were apprehended for allegedly raping and killing a 12-year-old girl in Assam's Biswanath district. The girl was hanged from a tree after the brutal crime that occurred on Friday. After examination, the accused had called the victim to a house on the pretext of organizing a party and raped her. In a shocking incident, a 25-year-old woman allegedly beat up her 6-month-old daughter to death in Uttar Pradesh's Aligarh district after her husband refused to buy her and her children new clothes for the Holi. The incident took place on Sunday. According to the police, the accused, Pinky Sharma, and her husband had an argument after he refused to buy new clothes for her and their children. She allegedly vented out her anger on her infant daughter, Sony, and thrashed her so badly that the baby died. The Supreme Court says no need to refer the petitions challenging the abrogation of Article 370 of the Constitution to a larger bench. A 5-judge Constitution bench presided by Justice N.V. Ramana had reserved its order on reference of the case to a larger bench on January 23rd. The central government had scrapped Article 370 in August last year, which ended special provisions according to Jammu and Kashmir and bifurcated it into two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir with a legislative assembly and Ladakh without one. The number of people killed worldwide by coronavirus has exceeded 3,000, as China reported 42 more deaths. More than 90% of total deaths are in Hubei, the Chinese province, where the virus emerged late last year. But there have also been deaths in 10 other countries, including more than 50 in Iran and more than 30 in Italy. Worldwide, there have been almost 90,000 confirmed cases, with numbers outside China growing faster than inside China. That's all in this bulletin. Thanks for watching. The news and updates will continue on the other side.